Someone I've needed so long. For once, I'm afraid I can go where life leads me. I know I will be strong. For once, I can touch what my heart used to dream of long before I knew. Someone warm like you would make my dreams come true. For once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me. Like it hurt me before. I found me someone I know won't desert me. I'll never be alone anymore. For once I can say it's mine, they can't take it. Long as I feel your love, I'm gonna make it. For once in my life, I got someone that needs me. For once in my life, I got someone who needs me. I can go where life needs me. I know I will be strong. For once I can touch what my heart used to dream of long before I knew. Someone warm like you, I would make my dreams. I said make my dreams, make my dreams come true. Oh, once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me. Who needs me? Can you dig it? Huh? I need it. Wow! For once in my life, that's it.
Thank you. Would you keep that hand going for this orchestra, ladies and gentlemen? Please. Everybody up. Beautiful.
Hello, this is Ron Joy. We're at the Beverly Hills home of Sammy Davis Jr. We're going to visit Sammy right before he starts on an extensive European tour. Let's go inside and talk to him.
Well, let me see if I get a cigarette here. My goodness gracious, it's a piano.
Are you ready for this trip?
I don't know, as ready as I can be, but I guess.
There's the part that you wish you had had, the part that you weren't smart enough to select or take at the time, you know, which is always dumb. They offered me Chicken George in and Roots. And I said, I don't think I want to play that, which is one of the great mistakes of all time.
And it really has a reverse effect on you. It makes you appreciate more the things that you are able to accomplish. There's a lot of performers that don't get offered parts, and there's a lot of performers out there who certainly have never had the shot at success that I've had. And I've been around for a long time. I'm a survivor in the, next to the auto industry, I think that show business has the highest morality, you know, in terms of people dying, you know. This business, boy, they wipe them out like anything, you know. So there's no sense in being sad about it.
Frank Sinatra.
It makes you aware.
Frank Sinatra.
Yeah.
What does that mean to you?
First of all, it means I wouldn't be sitting in this house. I wouldn't be where I am in the show business world. I wouldn't have been exposed to people. I'd have probably never went to Europe, ever, if it hadn't been for Frank. Because 25 years ago, Frank was saying to me, you've got to go to Europe. You've got to establish international connection. He says, and because you're a variety artist and because you make records, he says, you should go over and let these people know that you want to do good shows for them and so forth and so on. He said, just don't become an act that's indigenous only to America. Try to be the American performer that creates linkage between the other countries. And it was sound advice on a personal basis. Frank is, he's one of a kind, you know.
Who is George Rhodes?
George Rhodes is my musical conductor and has been for the past 27 years.
So it's a real kinship. Oh, he's family.
Honey, can I have my drink, please?
Okay.
Thank you, Ben.
You're welcome.
This is Altavis, and I know you guys know each other. So this is my Frau of 12 years, almost. This May it'll be 12 years we've been married. Mm-hmm. When she comes on the road with me, when I'm on tour, and whether it's here or in Europe, particularly in Europe, it makes all of those places that you're going to, and there's only about five or six places that we go that I know people, that we have friends. Hopefully you meet somebody over there, but with Altavis on the road with me, and we cook, and I'll cook after the show dinners, but it also, we get a chance to do both things. We get a chance to be together, and she's got some friends, for instance, in Switzerland, and she goes to visit. I've got some relatives in Switzerland. Mm-hmm. What you got?
My cousin.
Her cousin.
But you guys seem to have a nice friendship. Has it been that way from the very beginning?
No.
No.
We both said that quick enough.
Okay, then, Bob, shade the cameras. Maybe I'll grab a shot. Come on. Always timing. Timing. Timing's everything. I'll be right back. Yeah?
Mr. David, there's a long distance call from Stockholm for you.
From Stockholm? Okay, I got it, babe.
All right.
Hello? Yes, this is Sammy Davis Jr. Uh-huh. Oh, yes. Put him on, please.
This is he speaking. Hi. We got an echo. Well, that's what happens when you call from Stockholm. Yes, I'm looking forward to it myself. As a matter of fact, some of the crew's here, and we're doing some shooting in the house. What? Okay, wait a minute. Don't worry about it now. Everything is okay. It's going to take a little of a free time away, but I'll be more than happy to do it. He's asking about you already. Nobody cares about me. But I'm telling you now, it's done. You can put all the publicity out, anything you want. All right, my friend, I look forward to seeing you. Taxamika. Yeah, that's the only thing I still know. Okie dokie then. Goodbye. That's my man. They wanted me to do a benefit thing for the children, and we had a couple of days off, so it'll just be one of the days off. So that's no problem. Ah, back to the camera here. Now, if I can just get a reading here, so I will know what's going on. Oh yeah, okay. We'll go outside and shoot. Let me get one. Let's go ahead and view here. Mick, let me hear that turnaround in Singing in the Rain. Do a full chorus.
Pull out it only takes a moment. With Sammy, we got to get a voice check, sound check.
One, two, three, and.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling. Looking at clouds so high up above, the sun's in my heart and I'm ready to love.
Everyone from the place, come on with the rain. There's a smile on my face. I'll walk down the lane with a happy refrain, singing, just singing in the rain. I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling. Again, I'm laughing at clouds so dark up above. Sun's in my heart, and I'm ready for love. Let the stormy clouds chase everyone from the place. Come on with your rain. There's a smile on my face. I'll walk down the lane with a happy refrain, singing, just singing in the rain. And I'll walk down the lane with a happy refrain, just singing and dancing in the
nice thing about this room, like most of the house, it represents a part of me that has, I started collecting. I was the first black guy to ever do a Western on television about 15 years ago. I did a series of Riflemans, and you've probably seen them. But I started collecting Colt single action guns. And that led to Winchester rifles. These are all kind of important things. This, supposedly this gun here with the stag handles, these are all originals. This was a gun that was owned by the man that shot John Wesley Harding, one of the Texas Rangers that shot John Wesley Harding. This is a very special gun over here. This gun, which is encased within an encasement, was the gun that Gary Cooper used in High Noon. It's a very, very special gun to me because he was a good friend, and Frank Sinatra gave me Coop's gun. It's because I know that he loved you and you admired him a great deal. Shouldn't he want you to have it, and he gave it to me. And this is kind of a nice area to play pool or play poker. Sometimes the guys come up and we sit around.
Could you tell us something about your army days?
Oh, God. You don't want to hear about my army days. It was horrible. But it was no different than most of the black cats, because, you know, in 1943, there was no position for the black man in the military. And there had been no advancements. So everything was...
Complete segregation?
Complete segregation. And there were no equal rights, things that young people today, both black and white, take for granted. There wasn't even a Black History Month, you know, or a week or a day in that period. And it's nice to have survived long enough at the age of 56 to see a lot of things come into being that weren't there. This song about 8-9 years ago changed my entire life, and I started to listen to what the lyrics said and made up my mind that that's the kind of life I wanted to lead. Whether I'm right or whether I'm wrong, whether I find a place in this world or never belong, I gotta be me. I gotta be me. What else can I be but what I am? I just want to live, not merely survive. And I won't give up the dream of life that keeps me alive. I gotta be me, I gotta be me. The dream that I see makes me what I am. That faraway prize, the world of success, it's waiting for me if I'll heed the call. I won't settle down or settle for less. As long as there's a chance I can have it all, I'll go it alone. If that's how it must be, I can't be right for somebody else if I'm not right for me. I gotta be free, I gotta be free, daring to try to do it or die. Thank you.
Welcome to Amsterdam.
Thank you, babe. How you feeling?
Sammy.
Yes. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Wait a minute. How are you? Let me shake hands. Come on, you guys. Come over here, close.
Make it deep, divide. Make it deep, divide.
Show, yeah. Oh, show, show, yeah.
Show,
nice, Sammy.
It is nice to meet. It's nice to meet people my size.
And your age.
I've decided that most of the pictures I have in my collection are taken either from the penthouse, suite, the plane, or a car.
Here he is. And he's coming now.
You try to get in there.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Mr. Davis, welcome again.
Thank you.
It's good
nice
to see you.
Nice
how are you?
Back.
Good afternoon. How are you, sir? Hello.
Anyway, he finished
dinner.
Yeah, we got some stuff in the back.
Ja, prima. Kun je de bloemen op tafel zetten? Daar?
Ja.
Ja, prima. Goedemiddag. Uitstekend.
Thinking about 2 years from now, will I be able to do the all of the stuff, the tap dancing and the this and the that? Because we all must get older. And I would rather have them, my European audience, who have been so supportive over the past 20 years or so, I'd rather for them to see me up here than to see me when I'm, oh, well, you should have seen him years ago. He was good.
A 6 and a 4 don't make no sense to me in dominoes.
What are we going to do?
What is the rule on this, George? I want a ruling.
No, he can't read it.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
No.
What's the ruling, George?
Well, once it's played, you can't
but
play,
at
you can't
six
change the marking. You can't change the marking or scoring, and you can't change the thing. You just have
you
to play
it
out. It's in the book.
But I mean, you don't get no points for it, or take no points away from you?
No.
It's the game has to still go.
Even
if you mark it down.
It can't even itself out.
No matter.
Well, I didn't make it.
You're supposed to see it.
Well, you're the one that played it.
Yeah, but you're...
Because I played the 3 8.
I know, but the rules of the game is you're supposed to watch.
Thank you.
day, nothing will be the same again. After today, I'll make my claim to fame, and then the grass will be greener, the air will seem cleaner, and my life be serener. If heaven knows when, heaven knows when. After today I will have no more tears to cry. After today I will have bid my fears goodbye. I'll learn to live with laughter to stay after.
Really sort of my Shangri-La.
What's your secret ingredient for this dish?
Oh, no. Good chefs never give away their secret ingredients. I can give you a recipe and leave something out.
I didn't know you had to do the hard work, too.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's part and parcel of it, you know. A lot of people think that because you may be a celebrity or a personality or what have you, that you just cook and mess up all the dishes and never clean up. That ain't the way I learned.
Your kitchen in the States is gorgeous. I've seen that.
And it's a good kitchen, and it's a good working thing, and you don't think about anything else. You don't think about what time the show is. You don't think about, I wonder if this song's going to go over. The only thing you think about is, I hope the sauce turns out right.
Some things that happen for the very first time seem to be happening again.
Gee, what time is dinner, sir?
Don't talk to me while I'm trying to talk like this.
Okay.
How hard it is to walk with a level pot like that, in there, out there, without spilling any wine. You. You're
for my monkey.
Are they okay?
Leave it for a little
while. Take his coat.
So I'm saying,
I try hard.
And Sammy Davis has two applause. And give them all. Mr. Sammy Davis. Very welcome, Mr. Sammy Davis.
I just want to thank you all for coming this evening. On behalf of my family and myself, thank you for making this visit so nice by your presence here. And I would like to thank my man for singing all the good songs and for the group sounding so nice. Thank you very kindly.
Hey, Simon, sing something.
fidelity. Wake up to reality. But each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop. Cause I got you under my skin. Yes, I've got you, I got you under my skin. Yes, I've got you, Lord knows that I've got you. Yes, I've got you under my skin. Ha!
Consistency of good quality. Well, the whole secret is that when you come, I told you that, and when we were sitting at the bar, you don't leave America to come to Europe to do a series of concerts unless you come mentally, physically prepared. Hey, you can blow one show in Vegas. You know, if you're not, if the throat happens to go on you, I don't mean you should go out and dissipate to blow it, but I'm saying if the throat ain't working, because you've got a buildup of people and you've got credibility there, and they see you year in and year out. So they say, hey, he was better in Vegas, or hey, man, he's really cooking tonight. You've got that consistency going for you. You don't have it when you come to a place every 3 years. Simple as that.
Welcome to Stockholm, Mr. Davis.
Huh? Which one of the bedrooms do you have?
Another change room.
That one. That's where I'll do my stuff. My wife always gets what she wants in that big one. Because she can utilize that bathroom. I figured if we can put, let's check this out. See if we can put, connect this up.
Do you do commercials as well on American TV as Bob Hope does?
Yes,
a lot?
I do commercials. He does his commercials for savings and loan, banks.
Yeah. You?
I do mine for cooking stuff. I have a thing called Accent. This is what you use. You use this one. You can sprinkle this on there, and you'll love it. Accent, remember that. And it's a good product. And before that, I had Alka-Seltzer.
Because he needed it.
Would you sign in, please? The lads are waiting for you.
Darling, you go first.
Sign yourself.
Hello.
Good to see you.
How are you?
Fine.
Oh, yes. Good to see you. Thank you very much.
Did you bring this weather from California? Or?
It seems that way, isn't it?
It's lovely. I walked around today.
You're going out. I'll be right back there.
Say, man, what'd you do last night?
Steve saw the movie.
Death
Wish 2.
Death Wish 2?
Yeah?
You
got
it.
I'll
be done. It's that. Oh, yeah? What'd you guys have, man?
Potatoes.
Yeah.
I see.
Right there?
I'm saying, hit a high note.
Calm down, now. Just calm down. Let's don't get silly. Is this it, Dino? I don't like it.
Louise, you just give it one of those.
Can you give it one of those? When they pay to see me, then I'll give it one of those. Well, then they gotta wait. That's it.
Flooding the store?
I think so.
Very good.
But don't you know that you had to go around? Do-do-do-do-do.
Move that to the other side if you would.
Let's go, fellas. Let's go.
Time to go to work. Watch your steps, fellas, when you go around.
Hey, here we are. There we are again.
Is that it?
That's it. Let's go.
Please.
Thank you.
Thank you. Would you keep that hand going for this orchestra, ladies and gentlemen? Please. Everybody up. Beautiful.
Respect those of you in the audience who have given this up. I salute and take a bow to your integrity and your intestinal fortitude. And then on the other hand, I know a lot of cats who quit smoking, don't sing as good as I do. Yes, he did. You guys look awfully nifty tonight. I don't know what it is. You know what I think we should do tonight? And I'm sure the audience will understand it, because it is sort of, I keep it warm because I air conditioning, then I couldn't sing at all. So you'll have to forgive me for that. But I, for my guys, could you undo your ties, guys? Yeah. Please. All right, good. Now, as one who's your favorite entertainer in the world. I know he already made us take the ties off, man. Okay, look, here we go.
I've wined and dined on mullein stew, never wished for turkey. I've hitched, I've hiked, I've drifted too, from Maine to Albuquerque. When I go home to Harlem, I try to act real cool.
Hey, baby, what's happening?
But I make damn sure that when I go uptown, I never take Peter O'Toole. Social circles, they spin too fast for me.
You've gone too far this time, Sir Percy.
My, oh Bohemia, that's the place I want to be. Ha, ha, ha.
She gets too hungry for dinner at 8.
Whatever I give is a cat she eats.
And that's why the lady is in town. Won't go to Coney, Malibu is fine. Love the French Riviera in season divine. Refuses to believe Elizabeth Taylor is a friend of mine. That's why the lady is in town. Like that green grass growing up. Charles singing blues, she's flat, and that's that, and she's alone. When she lowers her lamp, that's when the lady is a tramp.
The orchestra, ladies and gentlemen.
Except free breath.
likes that free, fresh, wind in a wing. There ain't nothing she don't dig. She's a swinger, a singer, hates San Francisco. Thinks it's too hilly and bam. That's why the lady is a tram. Why the lady, 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 lady. Why the lady? Yeah, 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 yeah.
Flowers, sir.
Thank you, babe.
Very lovely.
They are lovely.
They're beautiful. Looks like they have any gotten.
What we can do? Yeah. That's baby dresses. What we can do is we'll take that. You can take that home with us. Jump so high, and then he lightly touched down. I met him in a cell in New Orleans. I was. I was down and out. He looked to me to be the very eyes of age. As he spoke right out, talked of life, talked of life, laughed, slapped his leg a step. He said his name was
Bojangles.
Then he danced a lick right across the cell.
grab his pants, take a better stance, jump up high. That's when he click his heels.
Thank you, love.
Then he let go that laugh. Lord, 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 he let go a laugh. Shake back his clothes all around. That was Mr. Bojangles. Mr. Bojangles. Mr. Bojangles. The man could dance. Told me of the times he worked with minstrel shows, traveling throughout the South. Spoke with tears of 15 years, how his dog and he, they would travel about. But his dog up and died. Dog just got old and died, and after 20 years he's still free. He said, I dance now with blue jazz lucky tucks. All my drinks and tips, but most of the time I spend behind these county bars. You see, son, I drinks a bit. Then he shook his head. See you dance again.